made Donald Trump, he said, fuck it, we all gotta die sometime. So he took a shit into a cup, stapled a used car salesman tie and tiny toupee onto that Trump turd, shoved some Mr. Potato Head hands not big enough for big boy work into the soft sides of that piece of shit, and said, go be president now. Donald Trump was God's suicide letter. We now have a president who's the human equivalent of saying, get off my lawn. An administration who is only competent in being racist and assaulting women. They are a tyrant team of cartoon villains turning Trump Tower into Cobra Island. Who the fuck thinks Meryl Streep is overrated? No wonder you don't think climate change is real. You don't even watch movies right. Donald Trump is the most racist president we've ever had, and that's saying a lot, because the first couple owned slaves. And I'm sure Trump would too, but judging by his finances, he could only rent. We are a nation built on white supremacy, built on patriarchy, and that shit still pumps through our veins the way Chris Christie dry humps a pillow with a picture of the White House printed on it. Shit! Racism is the only thing this country makes anymore since all the factories shut down. And hey, all lives matter, people. Number one, shut the fuck up. Number two, if you really felt that all lives matter, you wouldn't have voted for the game show host who's gonna star in the war that destroys all lives. Matter of factly, why did you vote for him? Cause you think he's gonna give you a job? Motherfucker made a living off of saying you're fired, you asshole. You got played because you're afraid of Mexicans. The only people I see going after your job is everyone from my school I tried to avoid sending me goddamn LinkedIn invitations. Donald Trump's trickle-down economic policy is gonna be pissing off a Trump Tower the way a Morton Joe handed out water, or the way he likes to shower in Russia. And hey man, getting pissed on is the least dirty thing Donald Trump's ever done, so own that shit. We can't even pray for Donald Trump's assassination because his creationist vice president wants to shock the gay out of people, like gayness is a ghost that comes to life and makes pottery like Patrick Swayze. Mike Pence believes AIDS is a punishment for anyone with a better sex life than him. And if you all are wondering what Mike Pence's sex life is, I assume it's shamefully punching himself in the dick while screaming Hail Marys and coming to the thought of taking away healthcare from poor people. We will not stop fighting until you are out of office. Do you think it stops with Chelsea Manning and Edward Snowden? This country hates you as much as your family does under their breath, and we will take you the fuck down. The only wall we will build is between you and Washington, between you and America, between you and your Twitter account, before you and your daughter's ass. You are a scared old man, giving the words overcompensation new meaning. You are Kylo Ren without the cool dad. You are Mr. Burns without Smithers. You are Donald J. fucking Trump, and the closest thing you have to friends are your two little robot sons who look like the profile picture of anyone who's ever murdered a sorority girl. So listen, you can sit in your tower with your Ku Klux Yes Men and with your statues made of gold, and you can pretend to be powerful, but the Klan are scared boys in bedsheets, and statues don't fight back. But we will. We will fight for the Mexicans you are scared of. We will fight for the Muslims you are scared of. We will fight for the women you are scared of, for the trans people that you are scared of, the kids with heart, with empathy, with kindness that runs through them the way you would run from a street fight right now. You started the wrong one, man. You will make us stronger. Give us something to unite against so we can all Power Ranger the shit out of you and make America great. Thank you very much. My name is Jamie Kelsey. Enjoy to live wildly. Have a great night. Thank you very much.